Oh, hey everyone. After searching for hours, I finally found Mia in this forest.
You'd think a robot would have some kind of location sharing setting.
Think about it. If you were lost, you'd probably just look at your cell phone. It could tell you where you are and give you directions home. But what goes into these apps that allow us to navigate our world so easily? To find out, we'll need to delve deeper into one of the five themes of geography, location. As we do, we'll discover how geographers describe locations, learn how to find exact locations on a map, and discuss how maps impact the way we view the world. Let's get into it. Geographers describe locations in two different ways, as absolute locations and relative locations. What do you think the difference might be between the two? Relative locations describe where something is compared to other landmarks or locations. It's like saying, the park is across the street from the school, or I live a mile west of the library. Absolute locations, on the other hand, describe the exact spot where something is on Earth. When your cell phone tells you your location, it uses coordinates, which are sets of numbers that represent absolute locations. I wonder what my absolute location is. Oh, 35 degrees north, 86 degrees west. Yep, those are coordinates. Absolute location can also be described as a street address because they tell us the exact spot where a business or home is located. But why does the difference between absolute and relative location matter? Well, imagine you're a geographer working with first responders after a major earthquake. You need to quickly identify locations where help is needed the most. Would describing absolute or relative locations be more useful? If you said absolute location, you got it. Precise coordinates or street addresses would direct relief teams to specific locations efficiently and accurately.
Now, imagine you're a geographer designing a new public transportation system in this city, planning bus stops that are convenient for residents.
Should you describe the location of the bus stops using absolute or relative location? Describing where bus stops will be located relative to other city landmarks will be more useful for city residents, like saying a bus stop should be next to the school or across the street from the mall. See, you're already thinking like a geographer. So, what are the coordinates of your current location? If you don't have a cell phone, no worries. You can figure out the coordinates of any location using a regular old map. And I have a challenge for you. My absolute location is 35 degrees north, 86 degrees west. Can you figure out where in the world I am using those coordinates and this map? That was challenging, huh? Don't worry, I totally didn't expect you to get that one. Let's break it down. Notice the lines on the map? These are latitude and longitude lines. Latitude lines run east to west. The equator is the most important line of latitude because it divides the Earth into the northern and southern hemispheres. Longitude lines run north to south. The prime meridian is the most important line of longitude that divides the Earth into the eastern and western hemispheres. Look at my coordinates again. What hemisphere do you think I'm in? Well, this part of the coordinates tells us my latitude, and it says north. This part tells us my longitude, and it says west. So I'm in the northwestern hemisphere. Now, notice how the lines on the map are numbered. The equator and the prime meridian are both labeled zero. So what do you think the numbers on the other latitude and longitude lines on the map tell us? Degrees of latitude represent how far north or south they are from the equator. And degrees of longitude represent how far east or west they are from the prime meridian. Let me give you another hint about my location. I'm in the United States. Let's zoom in there so we can see these lines a bit closer. Remember, I'm at 35 degrees north, 86 degrees west. What state do you think I'm in? If you still couldn't figure it out, no worries. All you have to do is find where the 35 degrees north line of latitude would be, right about here, halfway between 30 and 40. Next, find where the 86 degrees west line of longitude would be. Right here, just before the 90 degree line. Finally, find the spot where those lines intersect. I'm in the great state of Tennessee. Now try one on your own. What city is located at 48 degrees north and 2 degrees east? It's Paris, France. Now try it backward. What are the coordinates of this starred location in Australia? If you said 20 degrees south and 120 degrees east, you're right. If these felt challenging, it's totally okay. You'll get more practice in the lesson activity. So, are you wondering why we need to learn this if cell phones just do it for us? Well, being able to quickly identify coordinates is crucial for pilots, sailors, military personnel, and people in many other careers. Plus, this skill helps us understand how our phones instantly communicate our locations. Did you notice how the lines on that world map were kind of curved? Why do you think that is? Well, think about it. The Earth is a three-dimensional sphere, kind of like a beach ball. Imagine trying to stretch that entire beach ball onto a flat surface. What do you think would happen? It would get all ripped and crinkled. It would be nearly impossible to make it flat without distorting the shapes and patterns. This is the challenge geographers face when they try to represent the globe on a flat map. To solve this problem, they create map projections. A map projection is a representation of Earth's curved surface on a flat plane. Each projection has a purpose, but none of them are perfect. And those imperfections can impact how we view the world. There are many different map projections out there, but today we'll focus on two. Let's start with a Mercator projection, the most popular one. It accurately preserves directions between locations on Earth's surface, making it especially helpful for sailors in sea navigation. But check out Greenland and Africa. What do you notice? Greenland looks almost as big as Africa here, but in reality, Africa is 14 times larger than Greenland. The Mercator projection distorts the size of landmasses. Also, notice how Europe is just placed right in the center. This projection has been criticized for presenting a Eurocentric view of our world, meaning it emphasizes Europe and European perspectives instead of giving a balanced representation of other regions.
The Mercator projection minimizes the size and perceived importance of regions like Africa and South America.
Now, let's check out the Robinson projection.
What's similar and what's different about this and the Mercator projection?
The Robinson projection shows sizes of continents more accurately. Greenland is much smaller than Africa here, just like in real life. And even though Europe's still centered, by representing the true sizes of continents, this projection provides a fairer perspective of our world. This projection still isn't perfect, though. The shape of landmasses are distorted near the edges, and directions between two points aren't accurate, making it less useful for navigation. Understanding the accuracies and inaccuracies of different map projections helps us choose the right map for the right purpose. And it reminds us that every map has a perspective that can influence our view of the world around us. Well, 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 seems like we've checked off one of the five themes of geography off our list. Wait, do you remember seeing Dr. Atlas's business card? These must be the coordinates of his office. This is the perfect excuse to take a vacation. We can return his backpack and explore his city. 30 degrees north, 90 degrees west. I wonder where that is. Actually, you figure that out. I've got to get to the airport. I'll see you in the mystery city. Until then, keep exploring. See you next time. Hey, hey.